Hello students, welcome to Programming with C and C++ online classes. Today I am going to explain about the concept of switch statement. Actually it is also related to control statements. In the last classes we have completed if conditions and also if else condition and also nested if else conditions we have completed. But in this session I would like to explain about the switch statement. Actually till now we have checking only one value or two values, nothing but two conditions at a time. We are checking one condition till now. So now I want to check multiple conditions. By using switch statement. Actually switch statement capabilities like that, more than one condition. If you want to check more than one condition, for that we can use the switch statement. But if you want to check one condition, if condition is enough. So if you want to check one condition either in two ways, then we can use the if else conditions, based on true or false. Okay, but each and every control statements and also switch statements working with a true or false conditions. Okay, compulsory here we have to use the relational operators. Control statements, looping statements, all are working with relational and logical operators only. Okay, so if you want to create any condition, compulsory these operators must and should we have to use along in the condition statements like that one. So now let us start our session to explain about the switch statement. Okay, so a switch statement tests the value of a variable and compares it with multiple cases. Once the case match is found, a block of statement associated with the particular case is executed. Here break not there. So just default message is enough. So carefully observe. Here I have given syntax. So now I am writing now I am changing the font. Yeah, switch statement syntax. Here switch condition, carefully observe, condition or expression both are same. Okay, condition or expression both are same. In some programming languages we are using conditions, in some programming languages we are using expressions. Actually expression, condition, both are same, but you must have to use in the lower case letters because of C programming language is case sensitive. Compulsory you must have to use the lower case format because of all reserved keywords reserved with the lower case letters only, right? And next one bracket you need to open. If you want to check multiple conditions, here case 1, case case 1. Case is the keyword, 1 is the number, and here one colon symbol, here block we need to declare, here block we need to declare. Block means block of statements, right? Opening bracket and here closing bracket. So inside number of lines, number of statements we can use, right? Number of statements we can use. After that, break. Break. Right? Here, actually this is a syntax. For your understanding purpose, I just given this one block. Block means whatever the opening bracket and closing bracket inside, I mean in between these two brackets, whatever the statements you have written. So all statements completely related to that block only. Okay? So now I am removing this one. I think you have understood about that. So just for your understanding purpose, simply I can use the block. Colon. Next, break. Break is also, we have to use that one. Why we need to use the break keyword? If the case 1 is found, if the case 1 is matched with the given condition, then this block of code will execute, and after that break statement will break the execution. Will break the execution. But if the case is not matched, if the condition is not matched with case 1, again it will check the case 2. It will check the case 2. If the case 2 is matched, then block is executed. And colon. In the colon. Now break is the keyword. If the case 2 matched, block executed, the execution start here only by using break keyword. But the execution stopped by the break keyword. And if case 2 is not matched, again case 3. If the case 3 is matched, this block executed, this block will execute, and break statement will stop the execution. Like that, if you have number of comparisons, you can use the number of statements. You can use the number of cases you have to write. According to your project requirement, if you have 100 cases also, you can write, no problem. 1000 cases also, you can write, no problem. Like that, n number of cases you can write. N number of cases. And this block is also will execute, and break statement will stop the execution. Right? So if any case it will, if any case not matched by the given condition, so case 1 is not matched, case 2 is matched, case 3 is matched, like that case up to case n, anything not matched by the given condition. So in that case, we can use the default case. So default is the keyword. So default case, it will execute, and default block it will execute. So break keyword not required at last. Okay. If any case, case 1, case 2, case 3 and case n, any case it has not matched by the given condition, then default case will execute. Default case will execute. Understood? This is the switch syntax. Switch syntax. So here I have given diagram. If the switch statement given condition is, first it will check the case 1. If the case 1 matched, statement block executed, break statement is also to stop the execution and to stop the remaining checkings. Case 2, case 3, case 3, case 4, case n, up to case n, that remaining checkings it will break, it will stop the execution because of already case 1 matched. Again, why it need to check the case 2, case 3, case 4 and case n? Not required. It will waste of that, it is waste of that, I mean it's waste of the time for checking purpose, because of here the result we got at case 1 only. But if case 1 not matched, immediately the control will comes to the case 2. If the case 2 is matched, this statement block executed, and also break statement will stop the execution to check the remaining conditions. So that's why if the case 2 is not matched, and case 3, case 4, case 3, I mean case 5, case 6, case 7, like that, whatever the cases you have written, that all cases it will check by the control. If last one, if it anything not matched, any case not matched, default block will execute. Default statement will execute. Okay? After that, we will terminate the switch case. Now, I want to check the program wise. So now I need to write the program for your practical understanding purpose. Now I am opening developer C++ window. Now I want to check the weekdays. Switch demo. Okay. Hash include stdio.h. Now void main. Open bracket and closing bracket. Here int week. Weekday I want to check. Weekdays I want to check. So whatever the input I have passed, that related input is weekday or not. Okay, it will check. So now print the message. Enter 1 to 7 number. Choose between, choose any number between 1 to 7. Choose any number between 1 to 7. So after that you need to give the scanf function. Because of scanf function, allow the input percentile d and n, percentile d and v. Now switch week. Week is the condition. Opening bracket and closing bracket. So case 1 colon here. Block means this one. Print f. This is Sunday. This is Sunday. So after that, break statement. After that, break statement. So now I am adjusting in the single line. Don't confuse. So whatever the brackets you have written, everything that is under block only. Okay, so inside block I have declared the, I have printed the message. Inside block I have used the print function, right? So break is also completed. Now case 2, same I am pasting. So instead of 1 here, I need to paste second. This is Monday. This is Monday. So again I am pasting here. 3 is the option. Tuesday, right? Here again I am pasting 4. This is Wednesday. Now I pasted again here 5. So this is Thursday. Again I have pasted here 7 switch cases I need to configure now. 7. So this is Friday. Last one. 7. And this is Saturday. Now again default case required. Default open printf. So input invalid input. So that error message also want to represent na invalid input. If you configure, I mean, if you enter between 1 to 7, no problem. If you enter out of 7, then it will represent as a then it will print the default message invalid input, right? So here I just closed this bracket. So now I am saving this one, switch.c, save as type is all files. Now I am compiling. So 0 errors and 0 1 successfully compiled. Now I am executing. Enter any number between 1 to 7. Now I want to enter 7. So this is Saturday. So now I want to execute one more time. 0 is the value. Invalid input. Invalid input, it is the default message it is printing. So like that, if you want to check, if you want to check more than one condition, in that case we can use the switch statement. Switch control statement is very useful to check the multiple conditions, right? So switch statement is also over. Next, explain about the looping statements. In C programming language, loops are used to repeat a block of code, until a specified condition is false. Looping statements are also called iterative statements. For example, now I want to print college name. For that, one printf function I am using. Through the C program, I want to print GPODPGC. So now I want to print this message one time, no problem. If I want to print 3 times, so 3 printf statements I need to use. So now if I want to print this same name 1 crore times, so 1 crore times you have to write printf statements now. So that is also a burden, for the programmer to write 1 crore times. If you want to write this statement again and again and again, so it is also taking a very burden, and also computer processor is also taking the burden, and time is also consuming while executing time. The 1000 statements it is executing by the processor, so the processor will take by the will take the burden about this 1 crore statements. So in that case, if you want to print that number of times repeatedly same message, you have to use the loops. There are 3 types of loops. The first one is while loop, second one is do while loop, third one is for loop. First we have to see about the while loop. The while loop is used to repeat a block of code until a specified condition is false. So for that we have to see the syntax of looping statements. So while loop syntax, now we have to see. While loop statement. While loop syntax. While open bracket condition or expression okay, and open a bracket. Statements. So this is the syntax of while loop. This is the syntax of while loop. So in between, so after opening bracket and closing bracket, in between, if you want to iterate a number of times, this complete block, for example, this block contains 100 lines of statements. So 100 lines of statements also, 100 times it will execute. 100 times also it will execute. So for that, I am writing one program. While loop demo hash include stdio.h. After that, wired main. Open bracket, closing bracket. Int I print f. How many times you want to print? How many times you want to print your college name? So after that, you need to write the scanf function. Scanf function will allow the input and comma and I while opening bracket I comma input. Input is also required. So here, now we need to declare the starting point, I equal to 1. So while loop can start with 1 time. End with input given value. So it is less than or equal input. So now I want to print the message again. G Pullareddy degree and PG college. So now enter this one. After that, I plus plus increment operator required. So first carefully observe. I value is what actually? 1. Here initializer with 1 only. I value initializer with 1 only. And less than or equal to input. For example, if you enter the 10 as a input, the input variable replaced with 10. So 1 less than or equal 10. The condition true na? Here what are the operators we are using? Relational operators. Right? So I is 1, input equal to 10. I less than or equal to 10. So the condition true. So first the control will enter into the block. This print the message. G Pullareddy degree and PG college message it will print. After that, I plus plus, nothing but I value increment with 1 only. I plus plus means it will increment by 1. So I value is what actually 1. 1 plus 1, 2. I equal to I plus plus. So I value is incremented with 1. So nothing but it is replaced with 2. So then 2, again the iteration is going to come back. Again the iteration is coming back to the while loop. So the 2 less than or equal, I value is right now what? 2 value. 2 less than or equal input. Nothing but 10. So the condition is also becomes true. Again the control will enter into inside of the block. This message it will print. This college name it will print one more time. Then again it will increment. I equal to I plus plus. 2 plus 1, nothing but 3. So the control will come back to the while loop. 3 less than or equal to 10. So that condition is also false. Like that, 10 equal to 10. that increment is go 10 less than or equal to 10 if it will get, then the 10 time is also it will print. So 11th time the control, the condition is false, becomes false, then the control will not enter into the inside and the control will comes out for the while loop. Now I am saving this one, while dot c, save as type is all files. Now I am compiling this one. Now I am executing. So how many times you want to print your college name? 10 times. So 10 times is also it is not printing. Why? Something we missed here. Printf. So 10 value can store it. Sorry, here input we need to pass. So that is the wrong. Because of the input is storing into input variable. I initialized with 1 only. Okay. Now again I am compiling. Now again I am executing. 10 times. So it is infinitely running, right? Why it is running infinitely? Sorry, I plus plus is enough. Okay, here new line character must and should be required. Otherwise, the message it will print side by side, side by side. Now I am compiling again. Now I am executing. 10 times is the message. So 10 times the college name is printing now. G polarity degree and PG college. 10 times it is printing in the proper way. Okay. Every time it is breaking the line by using slash n character. Otherwise, if you want, if you haven't used any slash n character, this line, second line is also will print at this side only. And third line is also print at nothing but side by side it will print. So that is not a proper output. So you must have to format the function, print function, by using escape sequence characters. Then only you will get correct proper output. Here what, how to work the while loop, what is the syntax of while loop, everything you have understood now. Here I have given, carefully observe, here I have given diagram also, flowchart. If the text expression is true, then while loop body will execute. Again, it will come back to the while loop. Again, it will check the text expression. Test expression. If it is true, then again, body of loop it will execute. Like that, until it will get the false condition, it will check the, it will execute the while loop body number of times. When it will get the false condition, the control will not enter into the body of loop. Again, it will come back to the, again, it will go to the next line of statements. The while loop is terminated by the false condition. Okay. Here I have given while loop's working process. The while loop evaluates the test expression inside the parenthesis. Inside the parenthesis, nothing but here while loop parenthesis brackets we are using now. So inside we have configured one condition. So if the given condition is true, then this message will print. Again, it will increment. So like that, the number of iterations, circle is, it is going on, round circle, the number of iterations it will work. When it will get the false condition, then immediately the control will not enter into the block. Again, the control will come out to the next line of statement to execute. So that is the working process of while loop. Right? In today, I have completed switch statement as well as in the looping statements, introduction part is also over and while loop is also over. And in the next class, I would like to explain about the do while loop and also for loop. Today, I am going to ending this session. I hope you enjoyed this session. Thank you. Thank you very much.